So friends, once again I am here with one very good virtual class training software, and this is Microsoft Teams. Now this software is basically a paid version of the software. It has taken around 1770 rupees, means 1770 rupees, for 1 year subscription. And using this software one can connect with many students at a time. This is a subscription for 1 year, and a school can register for one single subscription or multiple users. With one user at a time, only one class can be taken, so it can, one user can be shared with many teachers. Now you have to first sign in the software, so you have to make a Microsoft account for that. So when you purchase the software, you have to make a Microsoft account, and you have to connect that account with this Teams. So that is another process, but here we are just looking for how can we take classes in Teams. So as simple as in logging the information, you have to first input your information as the user ID should be going inside it, and I am entering my user ID whatever I had registered with the Teams. So it is dot on Microsoft dot com. So that is one thing. Now when I am signing in, it will look for the ID, it will search for the ID, and if there is a registered ID, it will ask you the password. So you have to enter that password over here. After entering the password, the software will open for you, and it will show you the different menus and the creation of classrooms, and will show you how you can create a particular class. So we have logged in into our account. Now you can see when you log in first time in your account, this type of menu, this type of front end will come before you. Now here you can see that there are two numbers of Teams I have created. One is KV2 Kachrapada. So, and under each of these team, these things are nothing but they are channels. So you can create channels under a particular team. So our team name is KV2 Kachrapada, and inside it we have channels like CS12, IP12, like that. So let us create one more channel inside it. Say for example chemistry. So I am going to create a channel chemistry. So the channel name is chemistry 12 2020. So and you write the description, this is for taking chemistry classes of students in class 12 for session 2020-21, and then just add. It will create the channel, it will take some time to create the channel, and it will just create the channel for you. So here it is, the chemistry channel is created. So wonderful. Now you want to take class, right? So first you have to add participants in this channel. So what you have to do is, you have to go back to your Teams only, and from here you can add members to your team. So since there are many members that I have added earlier, now I am going to add one more member to the team. Say for example, I want to add few more students of our school who are biology students in my team, right? So what I will do, I will get their email address and I'll try to type it out. Say for example I have a member called named Swagat Sushnigdo 123@gmail.com. This is totally fake ID, but I am just entering. When you are adding a guest participant, this is a guest member because we have not created account for this in our team. So there are two types of members. One is guest members who are just invited using email addresses, and another is users. So to create users in your team, you need to register them properly, and for each user you have to pay $5. Okay, so but you can create members outside your organization as guests by using simple email address, right? They will not get the facilities, different facilities within the team software, like sharing the document, sharing the wikis, etc. But you can take online classes for them using this account. Okay, so what we will do, we will just create this member, add this member into our team KV2 Kachapada. So now you can see, as since this particular person Sushnigdo, I'm again typing it, Sushnigdo, was not there, 123@gmail.com was not there. Okay, so I will just, it will just present you with a menu, add Sushnigdo as a guest. So just click on that and add. Click on add, it will add Sushnigdo. It will give you some message, it may give you some error message, but it goes to the server. Okay, now you can see here, it is showing that Sushnigdo guest is added. Okay, or it may show you that the guest is added, though the guest is added, but it is having some error in the server. Don't worry about it, it is added. Now you close it. So we have created one channel called Chemistry 12, and under the our team KV2 Kachapada, and inside it, so in the KV2 Kachapada itself, you have to click these three ellipses. Okay, in our team we have to click these three ellipses, and then there, from there you have to add member, right? And in that you have to type the email address. So now we have in Chemistry, we have that particular member, added that particular member, right? Now I want to conduct a class in Chemistry. What to do? It is very simple. Simply what you have to do is, you will come here in the channel feed. This is called channel feed. ये जो नजर आ रहा area, ये channel feed है. Now what you have to do is, you simply, you can see here, there are a lot of tools which you can use in your channel feed. You can add videos in your channel feed, you can add movies, you can add documents, stickers, etc. Now this is live video, so you can conduct a live meeting. So this is Meet Now. As you can see, Meet Now menu is popping up. So click on Meet Now. Click on Meet Now, and here in this menu, in this particular menu, you just type Chemistry Virtual Class 1. Okay, Chemistry Virtual Class 1, and then click on Meet Now. Right, or you can schedule a meeting. So either you can meet now, if the meeting is started today only at this time, or otherwise you plan your meeting. So schedule, there is a scheduler, so always plan your meeting beforehand and invite the students. So it is better to plan ahead. So schedule a meeting, click on schedule a meeting, it will give you a scheduler. Now here you want to add your attendees. Now who will be attendees? You can add your team members or you can add guests, but those guests will appear here only when, if you have added them in the team, as we have added Sushnigdo 123. So what I will do, I will here again, I will type Sushnigdo, and once you are typing here, the software will remember his or her ID. You don't have to remember every time the ID. Or what you can do is, you can make a short file and keep all the students' ID over there and paste it over here. So Sushnigdo 123. Now you can see, as I am typing, it is showing me that it is a guest. And the Sushnigdo 123 is a guest. So just click on that and it is added. So you are going to invite Sushnigdo 123 as a guest. Okay. Now you can see here when you want to schedule your class. So 8th April morning session you want to take. So 6 a.m. or 6 p.m. Say for example you want to take the class at 8:30 a.m. So just schedule it at 8:30 a.m. tomorrow. So just make it 8:30 a.m. Okay, so this is 8:30 a.m. and up to which time? So you take it and make it 9:30. So 1 hour class you want to add, and you can schedule it repeatedly, means every day you want to schedule the same class at same time. So what you have to do here, you just write here what, every day weekday, every weekday Monday to Friday, or daily you can take daily also, occurs 4 by 8, so you can tell like that. Okay, now you can see here KV2 Kachapada chemistry 12, it is added over here. You can add location, or you can write your now here what you will write, you will write the instruction that you want to give to the meeting members, means attendees means your guests. That mail, the body of the mail should be typed here. So dear students, this is virtual class 1, please attend on 8th at 8:30 a.m. okay, this much. And then you can just you can add more members, not only Shushnik though, you can type here other members name also, no problem. So additional members can be added, as many as possible. So you can just copy and paste the email IDs, and there that will be sent. And here you just put a send. Okay, so you have sent that invitation. Now you see in your feed this is scheduled, it the class is scheduled it in your feed, right? And the meeting will held on 8:30. Now suppose I am coming on 8th at 8:30 morning, what I will do now, I will start my meeting. So what I will do, just click on this. Okay, sorry, you don't have to click on that, you just keep it like that. Okay, now here you can see here, there are many members over here, 41 guests it is showing here, because I have added all the members, all the email IDs earlier. So 41 guests are there, right? But I am not inviting everybody now. Now what I will do, this is angry reaction, I will not give angry reaction, I will give a wonderful reaction, okay, amazing reaction. Now what I will do, simply I will help view the meeting details. I don't have to go to view meeting detail. Now I want to start my meeting. So what I will do, I will just simply click on video, and here I will write what, meet. So meeting will be started at that particular time, and the invitation has gone to your students. The invitation has already gone to your students. You have invited your student for the meeting. Now on that stipulated day at 8:30, what you will do, you will simply click on this meeting menu, type your meeting, virtual class 1, at 8:30 you just type virtual class 1, and then simply chemistry 12, and simply press on meet now. Don't schedule it again, because you have scheduled earlier. Now you are coming to the meeting. So this is your meeting. Here you will just add. Now you can see here these many people are waiting, the suggestions are given, because they have attended my previous session, and that's why they are there. Now you can invite someone here. Suppose you want to invite someone that particular person for whom you have given the meeting invitation, right? That person's address should be entered over here. So suppose Shushnikdo, you want to add to connect to Shushnikdo. What you will do, Shushnikdo, type Shushnikdo here, it will come, just click on it, and it will dial to the Shushnikdo. In the real time situation, it will dial to the Shushnikdo. If Shushnikdo is available on the Teams, of course he will be available, because beforehand you have informed him. So now it is showing unavailable, because this is a fictitious email address that does not exist, right? And or he may be a person, but he has not installed Team, or he is installing Team, he has installed Team, but he is not active. It may be possible like that. Now let me connect to a real person. Say for example, I want to connect to this person, Pali Paul 8140. His email address is there. but I don't want to reveal the name. Just let me connect to this person whether he is there or not. Arpan, are you here? Are you listening me? Ask to join. Just click on ask to join. There is an option called ask to join, and if the person is there, he will respond to your call. He will respond to your call, right? Or otherwise, you invite him on the real time basis. That's it. This much has to be done for taking the class. Now, suppose you are connected and you are taking your class. As soon as that person is being connected here, let me show you. Let me show you. I'm going to connect in the real time. I'm going to connect with say for example, Abhinav. I am calling Abhinav to get him connected with this thing. So you can see here that person P. Ali Paul having the address, he is not available, and since he is not available, he cannot respond to your call. So that person who is available only, that person can respond to the call, right? So now you can see I am going to connect with a few people over here. There are people who are sitting over there and can attend this class this time only. So Swagata was just calling me, so I will connect to Swagata Biswas, and one more fellow is there, Vivek is there, so I will connect to Vivek. Okay, so emails are already saved, so don't worry about that. Now you can see that these two people have connected. Okay, now you can see her voice is coming. Swagata's voice is coming here. Swagata, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
You can speak, and you can show your video also, no problem, no issue with that. Okay. Okay, now you can see I have connected with Swagata, and she is connected over there. And you may ask your students to switch off or disable their audio and visuals, or you may ask them to connect. Okay, like that there will be many connections which you can see over here at a time. Now you can see Swagata is here, so he is connected live, and now we can have our classes over here. Okay, now you can see that. Okay, Swagata, you can switch off your video now. Okay, no problem, no issue with that. Okay, so here we have what? We have menus like we have turn off camera. You can turn off your camera. Say suppose you don't want your camera to be enabled, so you just switch off your camera. Camera will not be visible to them. Or you can switch it on anytime. You can turn off your mute your microphone if you don't want to your student to hear your voice. Then unmute it, or otherwise unmute it and show it. Now here one very important thing is there, share. So you can share many things. You can share your desktop, you can share window, you can share PowerPoint files, you can share browse, you can share whiteboard. There is whiteboard, you can share. The best part is just share your desktop, and whatever will be there in your desktop will be shown to the students. So just click on desktop, go to the desktop. Now I am going to do something. Say for example, okay, I'm going to, okay, somebody is calling. I have to receive that call. Maybe Vivek has joined, I think. Vivek has joined. Okay, he is unavailable. So, just going back to the shared thing. So, as you can see, there is a boundary, red boundary. That means this particular part of your screen is shared. So, whatever you will do here will be seen by your students. Swagata, I hope you are able to see my screen. You can speak out, Swagata. Okay, now if you want to, if you want your now you here you can see there are various menus. So here one menu is in the left side, there is a menu called activity. Just click on activity, you will see everybody's activity, right? You can click on teams, you can click on teams, and you can go to your virtual class which was just continuing. So you can join that virtual class that was going on. Now nobody is there. Since nobody is there, so she got disconnected. Okay, and then there are chats, right? There are chats which you can just have with your students, right? Chatting can be done with your students. Now if you want to share what your screen with them, what you have to do, just go for the video and use this menu share. You, in the video itself there is a share option, just click on share, and you can just have your desktop shared or your virtual class shared, or whiteboard, you can take help of whiteboard, or you can browse. Suppose you want to share a file. So for example, you can now it is asking you to browse from your team channel or OneDrive or upload from your computer. You can click on from your computer and you can choose any file, but now it is only allowing you to have Microsoft PowerPoints, right? So PowerPoints can be uploaded and you can show the PowerPoints to them, right? So you can choose and show the PowerPoints, or you can just simply browse your OneDrive. If you have OneDrive facility from your cloud, you can upload any file. Now so for example, I have desktop. In my desktop I want to start, I want to share one board, this one, that whiteboard. So I have one software called Anote. You can also download and install it in your machine, means PC. So this is IPVO Anoter. So this is IPVO, just remember the name and install the software, and from there you can have a whiteboard. You can start a whiteboard, ek whiteboard aap khol sakte ho, and you can start writing on it. Okay, and whatever you are writing here will be shared back to your students. So aapko students ko wo dikhai milega, and it is very good whiteboard with a good gestures and all that. Okay, so this is how you share your desktop. So whatever software you will play here, that will be shared to your students. I think this is not troublesome. Now let us come to the other options. There are chat. There are chat option. You can click on chat and your meeting chats will be shown on the right side. Okay, everybody can chat over here. Hi students, right? You can chat. Suppose you want to add somebody in the meeting, in the mid session, just click on this icon. This there is a team icon over here. Besides chat, there is a team icon. Click on team icon, and here you can invite anybody else. Say for example Vivek. Now Vivek has joined. Vivek, can you listen me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you can see that Vivek has joined. Please switch on your camera. No problem. No issue with that. So
there is no electricity.
Okay, there is no electricity. Okay, no problem. No issue. So you are using it from your desktop or mobile?
Desktop.
Okay. So Vivek has joined with a torch, with a desktop. Okay. डेस्कटॉप में देखना ज़्यादा अच्छा है, आप इसमें ज़्यादा अच्छा कनेक्ट कर पाओगे. मेरा साउंड कैसा आ रहा है आपको? ठीक आ रहा है? सही आ रहा है? क्लियर आ रहा है. सो दैट इज क्लियर. ओके, सो विवेक इज शोइंग सेइंग दैट इट इज क्लियर. सो दिस आर द फ्यू मेनूज ओवर हियर, और आप अपना क्लास आराम से ले सकते हैं इसको. और यहाँ पर एक मेनू है रिकॉर्ड करने का. यू कैन रिकॉर्ड योर क्लासेज, राइट? सो रिकॉर्डिंग मेनू इज ऑलवेज देयर. जस्ट let me see where the record menu is there. Okay Vivek, you can disconnect your camera, no problem. So record option is there. So simply, as simple as that, this is here only more actions. In the more actions there are three dots, no, more actions dot is there. Just here you can start recording your class. So the class will be recorded and it will be streamed in the Microsoft Stream software, means the cloud. It will be streamed into the Microsoft cloud, from where you can share it to your student who have not attended the session. I think this is clear. This much is clear for you. Teachers, you please use it. And अगर problem आता है तो आप मुझे बताइए, ज़रूर बताइए, consult करेंगे और इसमें जो भी होगा हम लोग देख लेंगे. और चूंकि ये सिंगल यूज़र है, अभी आपको मल्टीपल बेनिफिट्स नहीं बता सकते, बट क्लास लिया जा सकता है. कल आप क्लास लीजिए, 25, 26, 27, 28, 30, 40 बच्चों को एक साथ बैठा कर देखिए क्लास में क्या आपको फीडबैक मिल रहा है. ओके, सो आई होप दिस इज़ अंडरस्टूड.